Biff's Gaming Videos. Joysticks and joypads.
Trackballs and mouse pads.
Swimmers and my guns.
Fun.
Alien invasions.
Robotic invasions.
Dungeons and dragons.
Fun.
Home runs and touchdowns.
Jungles and ghost towns.
Videos from Biff Sun.
Fun.
This is Congo Bongo for the Atari 5200 Super System. It is a port of the arcade game from Sega. If you take a look at the opening title screen right there, in the arcades they had animation there and a different type of effects between screens, but that definitely looks like an Atari 8-bit. You can tell by the font, the way it looks. The basic premise is this. You've got a guy that is seeking revenge against an ape called Bongo. Now, Bongo set fire to this hunter's tent, giving him a hot foot. Literally a hot foot. Because he got the tent and he wants to take revenge. So he has to jump and go up to the top of the screen, up to where Congo Bongo is. And if he does, then he goes to the second screen. And there's a little bit of animation right, the little slide. On the arcade, there were four different screens. There was a Primate Peak, the Snake Lake, Rhino Ridge, and Lazy Lagoon. The Atari 5200 version only had the first two. The ColecoVision had three of them, and the Intellivision had four. So as far as ports go, this was not a good port to begin with. It only had two of the four levels. And the actual arcade game kind of sucked to begin with. And this particular version sucks even worse. It's almost like a version of Frogger meets Donkey Kong, but you know what? The first screen, you're just jumping, and you have no other weapons, you just jump. And you're trying to jump over these things again, and it's just not that good. It's not like Frogger anyway. The graphics don't look that good, it's really cheesy, the game is tough to play. This is a horrible, horrible game. I don't know why Sega decided to port this over to anything. I guess because they had arcade games and they wanted to make money. Hey, we've got a game here, let's port it over, so they did. And you're moving around and you have these little coconuts that look, I don't know what, they look like watermelons actually. And you have these monkeys down there. In this particular level, how about set up, the monkeys don't attack you, but you have to go around and it's the same exact thing. You go around the thing and you just jump over the little waterfall there, the lake, and then you go up to the top. And it goes over and over and over. This is really, really boring and a bad game. Just, I would avoid this at all costs. I'm giving this game a D, and I'm being nice here. This is a horrible port of a horrible game. Some people may like it, but you know what? It's not fun to play. You play it for like 2 minutes, and you go, oh, that's it? And you'll never play it again, trust me. I give this game a D.